good Friday morning, afternoon, or evening, whenever this finds you on Friday. I hope you've had a good day so far. We've been going through this week, five reasons why you should share the faith, you should tell others about Jesus, and we're up to reason number four, and we find it in Acts chapter 1, verse 8, and a couple other verses and sections of the Bible and Scripture. So I want to read Acts 1:8 for you, and then we'll talk about it. Acts 1:8 says this: Jesus promises the disciples, "You'll receive power when the Holy Spirit comes on you, and you will be in my witnesses in Jerusalem and in all Judea and Samaria and to the end of the earth." And here we see Jesus kind of sets the stage for every Christian's circles of sharing the gospel. You notice, it's almost like, and maybe you've done this, I've done this, when you were a kid, you went to the lake and, you know, your dad was fishing or other people were fishing, and instead of fishing, you decided to just mess up everybody's day and throw rocks into the lake. And you notice when you throw one of those big rocks in the lake, there's a big splash, and then there are a bunch of ripples that flow away from that big splash. And Jesus tells us to do this: make a big splash where you are. He says, "You'll be my witnesses in Jerusalem." That's where the disciples were at that time. So think about that in our context. Our hometown, our home area is Huntington, Barbersville, Milton, Salt Rock, Proctorville, Canova. That's our local area. And it's up to us, because Jesus has placed us in this area, to make a big splash in our area. So hopefully we're finding ways, even though we're quarantined, to reach out to people who don't know Jesus and to share the message of Jesus, whether that's posting a verse on Instagram to where people can see, whether that's kind of just reaching out to people who are having a tough time, because you can tell by the way their posts are looking, they're really kind of down in the dumps and depressed. We're reaching out to them, making a big splash in our neighborhood, in our hometown. But then he says, "You'll be my witnesses in Jerusalem." Then he says, "In all Judea and in all Samaria." So think about that as our region or our country. You know, we can be lights to our country and to our surrounding region by the way that we engage with culture and by the way that we make a difference where we are. And then finally, he says, "And to the end of the earth." So that means that our responsibility as a disciple of Jesus doesn't just end with reaching the people in Huntington, that we're supposed to be actively involved and actively participating in reaching people around the world. Now, so Jesus gave this command 2,000 years ago. How are we doing in reaching people around the world? Well, another part of Jesus' command that we see in Matthew 28, he says that we need to make disciples of all nations. And that word for nations is ethnos, which kind of means ethnic groups. The International Mission Board did a study of all the different ethnic groups in the world, and it found that there were 11,749 different people groups or different ethnic groups in the world. So how well have we done in reaching those people? Well, what we've learned is that 3,228 ethnic groups have still never heard the message of Jesus. You know, all the churches that we have on the corner in Huntington, all the streams that we see of youth groups and churches streaming during this COVID-19 pandemic, there are places in the world where no one has access to the message of Jesus. What do we do about that? Well, I think the first thing we do is we support the missionaries who are working out of our church. Did you know our church supports missionaries in, I believe, over 90 different countries? So that's exciting. And by the way that we give money toward that, toward their ministries, by the way that we write and encourage them, we get to be a part of what God is doing across the world and reaching these unreached people groups. Another way that we can get involved is by going on short-term mission trips. And while our youth group short-term mission trip has been postponed, you know, some of you are going to have the opportunity to go in a year and get to go outside of the country and see how God is moving in other parts of the world. Another study showed this: 81% of Christians in America realize that it's their responsibility to tell people about Jesus. But 61% of Christians have not shared their faith in the past 2 months. And we wonder why there are still 3,228 ethnic groups that need to be reached. So my encouragement for you is not to be overwhelmed by the 3,228 ethnic groups that haven't received Jesus. My challenge for you today is to find one person that needs to hear about Jesus and tell them today, this weekend, on Friday. Have a good day. I'll see you tomorrow on Saturday.